Hello, welcome to another module in this massive open online course on the principles of CDMA, MIMO, OFDM, wireless communications. So today we are going to start looking at CDMA, wireless communication systems. So we want to start looking at CDMA, and CDMA, as we all know, we have seen in the very first module, it stands for code division for multiple access. That is the full form of CDMA, as we have seen in the very first module itself. And CDMA is a key technology which is used in several 3G wireless standards. For instance, CDMA is used in wireless standards such as WCDMA, which is wideband code division multiple access. It is used in HSDPA and HSUPA systems. It is used in CDMA CDMA 2000 and 1X EVDO, and all of these, as we had already seen, these are various 3G wireless systems. So CDMA is used in WCDMA, HSDPA, HSUPA, that is high speed downlink packet access, high speed uplink packet access, CDMA 2000, 1X EVDO, and these are several different 3G wireless systems. So CDMA is a key technology, since it is used in several 3G wireless communication systems. It is a key technology, and understanding it is very important to understand the properties or some of the key technologies which have led to the progression of wireless communications, right. So what is CDMA? CDMA is a multiple access technology. So CDMA, what is CDMA? CDMA stands for code division for multiple access. So CDMA is a multiple access So CDMA is a technology for multiple access. Now what do we mean by multiple access? Multiple access is a very important component of any wireless communication system, and it can be explained as follows. For instance, let's say I have a base station and let's say this base station, which I am representing by BS, let's say it's transmitting to two users. Let us take a simple example. Let us say this is user 1, let us say this is user 2, and the same base station and these two users are connected to the base station over the common channel, which is the air interface. This is the common radio channel, or also the common air interface. We can also call this as the radio channel. So the same base station is transmitting to multiple users. It is transmitting to user 1 as well as user 2, and in fact in practical scenario it is transmitting to several users, several tens or even hundreds of users simultaneously. So these users with their mobile devices are able to simultaneously access the base station over the common radio channel. That is, unlike a wireline channel in which there is a dedicated wire between the transmitter and receiver, there is no dedicated channel between the transmitter and receiver. These several users are, or these multiple users are simultaneously connecting to the base station over the common radio channel, and therefore these multiple users share the same radio channel. So, what we have is basically we have multiple users they share so multiple users are sharing this common channel. So, there has to be a mechanism or there has to be a protocol to enable these multiple users to simultaneously share this radio channel, and this technology is termed as the multiple access technology. And this mechanism through which multiple users share the common radio channel, this is termed as your multiple access. This is termed as the multiple access technology, and CDMA is one such multiple access technology. There are several multiple access technologies. For instance, you might have heard of TDMA, which is time division for multiple access, which is used in GSM. So, TDMA, which is basically time division for multiple access, this is basically time division for multiple access, which is used in our 2G wireless systems such as GSM, which we already seen in the first module. There is the global system for mobile communication, where different users are allocated different time slots. So, this is user 0, user 1. So, this is user 0, user 1. User 2 and so on, and these are multiplexed or multiple users have different time slots. So, this is the slot corresponding to user 0, slot 0, this is the slot corresponding to user 1. So, different users are allocated different time slots. For instance, this is used in GSM, that is the global system for mobile communication, and the basic idea is that different users are allocated different So, we have TDMA, which is time division for multiple access, in which multiple users connect to the base station in different time slots. This is known as TDMA, that is time division for multiple access. Similarly, the frequency domain analog of this is known as FDMA, which is frequency domain or frequency division multiple access, in which different users are assigned different frequency bands for transmission. So, FDMA, which historically is even prior to TDMA, that it was used in first generation wireless communication systems, in which different users so this is in the frequency domain in which different users are allotted different frequency bands. So, this is band 0, this is band 1. So, what we have is different users are allocated different frequency bands, and this is termed as FDMA, which stands for frequency division for multiple access, and this is used in the first generation wireless communication systems, and this technology FDMA is used in first, that is the very first generation of wireless communication systems. So, what we have seen is, we have seen TDMA, which is time division for multiple access, in which the different users, mobile users, are allocated different time slots, and then we also have FDMA, or frequency division for multiple access, in which the different users are allocated different bands in the frequency domain, and each user transmits over his appropriate frequency bands, and thereby multiple users are able to transmit simultaneously over the common radio channel. And CDMA similarly is a multiple access technology in which different users are allocated different codes. So, CDMA is also a multiple access technology, and the name itself, so CDMA is code division multiple access, in which different users are allocated different codes. So, CDMA is code division for multiple access, and the different users are allocated different codes. So, it uses, it basically uses the concept of codes for multiple access. So, CDMA uses codes for multiple access, and different users are allocated different codes for transmission over the radio channel. And this can be explained with the aid of a simple example as follows. For instance, let us take a two user scenario, CDMA with two users, let us call them user 0 and user 1. Right. Now, let us also allocate the following codes. So, code 0 for user 0, let us denote this by this vector 1, 1, 1, 1. So, it contains 4 elements. These elements are also known as chips, and code 1 of user 1 equals 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1. So, we have two users, we are considering a two user CDMA scenario with two codes C0 and C1. Code 0 is 1, 1, 1, 1, and code 1 is 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1. Each code contains 4 elements. And also now, let A0 denote the symbol of user 0, A0 equals symbol of user 0, A1 equals is the symbol of user 1. What we are going to now do is, we are going to multiply the symbol of each user by the corresponding code, and then we are going to add these two signals. So, what we are going to do now is multiply symbol of each user with the respective code. Therefore, we have A 0 times C 0 equals A 0 times his code, which is 1 1 1 1, and this is equal to basically A 0 A 0 A 0 comma A 0. Fine. Also, we are going to multiply the symbol A 1 of user 1 with his code C 1. So, this gives us A 1 into C 1 equals A 1 times 1 minus 1 minus 1 1, which is equal to A 1 minus A 1 minus A 1 and A 1. Now, we are going to generate the sum signal or the combined signal at the base station, and this is done by adding these two signals. So, this combined signal is generated as the sum. So, we have the sum, which is equal to A naught times C naught plus A 1 times C 1, which is equal to A naught A naught A naught A naught plus A 1 minus A 1 minus A 1 A 1, and therefore, the sum signal is given as A naught plus A 1, that is the first element. Second element is A naught minus A 1, third element is A naught minus A 1, fourth element is A naught plus A 1. So, this is the combined signal. So, this is the sum signal. What is this? This is the sum signal or the combined signal corresponding to the two users, that is user 0 and user 1. So, what have we done? We have multiplied symbol A 0 with code 0 of user 0, we have multiplied symbol A 1 with code C 1 of user 1, and then we have performed the sum, or we have taken the sum of these two signals, and the sum signal is transmitted over the common air interface or over the common radio channel. So, the sum signal is transmitted over the common radio channel, and from this sum signal each user has to extract his own symbol, that is user 0 has to extract symbol A 0 and user 1 has to extract his symbol A 1. So, from this common signal, from this sum signal, each user, that is both user 0 and user 1, each user has to extract his corresponding symbol. And let us see how this is done. Each user correlates with his own code, that is user 0 correlates with code 0, which means he multiplies each element of the signal with each corresponding element of the code and takes the sum. So, user 0 correlates with his code C0, that is multiplies element by element that is you multiply the received signal, each element of the received signal with the corresponding element of the code and then take the sum. For instance, the received signal is, we have the element, the code is C0 is 1, 1, 1, 1 and the received signal is basically, we have the received signal which is given as A0 plus A1, A0 minus A1, A0 minus A1, A0 minus A1 and therefore, we multiply each element of the code with the corresponding element of the signal and then we take the sum of all this. So, 1 times A0 plus A1 is A0 plus A1, A0 plus A1 plus 1 times A0 minus A1 is A0 minus A1 plus 1 times A0 minus A1 is A0 minus A1 plus 1 times A0 minus A0, I am sorry, this is A0 plus A1, A0 plus A1 is A0 plus A1. And once you add all these things, you can see that the A1's cancel and what you have is 4 times A0 and therefore, what you get is 4 times A0, which is the symbol of user 0. So, A0 is the symbol of user 0. By performing this correlation operation with C0, which is the code of user 0, you are able to extract 4 times A0, which is basically nothing but it is a scaled version of the symbol A0. So, user 0 is able to extract his symbol A0 from this common signal that has been transmitted over the radio channel. By performing this correlation is an element by element multiplication with the code followed by the sum. Similarly, user 1 can now correlate with his code C1 and similarly extract a symbol A1. Let us look at this. Let us look at for user 1, his code is C1, which is, if you remember, his code is 1 minus 1 minus 1 and 1. The received signal, the sum received signal is A0 plus A1, A0 minus A1, A0 minus A1 and A0 plus A1 and you multiply element by element and followed by taking the sum. So, we have the first element is A0 plus A1 times 1. So, this is A0 plus A1 plus A0 minus A1 times minus 1, this is A1 minus A0 plus A0 minus A1 times minus 1, which is A1 minus A0 plus A0 plus A1 into 1, which is A0 plus A1. And once you take the sum of all these things, you can see now that the A0's cancel and what you have is 4 times A1, which is nothing but a scaled version of the symbol transmitted by user 1 and therefore, user 1 is able to extract or recover cover his symbol, that is A1. So what we have shown is the following thing. We have shown that the base station can multiply the symbol of each user with the corresponding code, that is symbol A0 with code 0 of user 0, symbol A1 with code 1 of user 1, then take the sum of these two signals and transmit this common signal over the air, and each user can further correlate this received signal with the corresponding code of the user to extract his own received symbol. Thereby, multiple users are able to simultaneously access or simultaneously connect to the base station or simultaneously receive information symbols from the base station by using these codes, which are C0, C1 and so on for more users. And therefore, this is code division for multiple access, where the codes are being used by these different users to simultaneously receive information symbols from the base station. And this phenomenon of basically multiplication by the code and sum and transmitting the sum signal by the base station and correlation by the different users to recover their transmitted symbols, this is the key principle behind CDMA, which is code division for multiple access. So this is the key principle behind code division for multiple access, and therefore since these codes are being used for multiple access, therefore this is termed as which is basically CDMA. And this phenomenon where different codes are being used by the base station to transmit the information symbols corresponding to the different users, and the different users are able to simultaneously access the base station through their corresponding codes, this is termed as code division for multiple access. So this illustrates the principle behind CDMA, and we will conclude this module here and continue with other aspects of CDMA in the subsequent modules. Thank you very much.